Hello, hello again. We are back. We are super excited now. And I see Brigitte is already here, ready to shoot. So I'm super excited to announce the person that we think of when we talk about open data, Brigitte Lutz, who is the Data Governance Coordinator of the City of Vienna. She's also, and please correct me if I'm wrong, she's also the co-founder of the Cooperation Open Government Data Austria. And she will talk today about data governance in the capital of digitalization, Vienna, strategy and challenges. Brigitte, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for the invitation. I want to share my screen now.
I can hear you, and I cannot see your screen yet.
Okay, one moment, please.
Mm-hmm. Yes, perfect.
But now. So welcome to Vienna. I'm working for this beautiful city since nearly 40 years. I have started there as a programmer in the ICT department. I have made a lot of jobs there, like project leads and process management. And since 10 years, I'm working in the department of ICT strategy. And I'm very happy to have this conference here in Vienna, because you see, we are an international city, and I think we are a city of innovation and network, and a city of data, so I'm very happy to have you here. What is my job as a data governance coordinator? Yes, I'm looking all over the data of the city, and maybe you know all these catchwords like data silos, multiple data entries by hand, or nobody is responsible for some data, or BI or data analytics are not easily made because you don't know the golden source of a data. So we wanted to start our Data Excellence Initiative some years ago, I think 4 years ago. And we said that the city of Vienna wants to become data excellent. And we have to set measures in data quality management, in data administration, and to become better in the whole data life cycle. So we started the same time from top down and bottom up. We worked on a data excellence strategy. We worked on guidelines on the data excellence topics, and we saw that we had to reorganize the structure and the processes in data management in the city. Maybe you know some figures about Vienna. We are nearly 60,000 employees in the city, including the hospitals in Vienna. So there is a lot of do in this field, and we have a lot of data in the city, because we think that data is the digital IQ of a city. As we heard in the speeches of both Julias before, there is a huge amount of data, and the development of the digital transformations gave us opportunities to work with this data. So I think information and knowledge of a city is also based on data, and it's a production factor for a smart, for intelligent, and for a digital city. I have an example for you where you can maybe use data. If you go outside or you look outside of the window, maybe you see a tree and you want to know which tree is it, which kind of tree is it, how old is it, or maybe you want to know how many trees are in the city of Vienna. Their data can help you. So our vision is that the city of Vienna provides reliable information and data as a central value of an open administration of the future. And we want to create a high benefit for the citizens in the city, for the economy and science, and also make a contribute to an efficient execution of the administration tasks of the city. Our data excellence strategy is based on three pillars. The first pillar is the data governance. This forms the basis for coordinated data management rules.
Sorry to interrupt you. I just see that actually your slides are, I see that the slides are a bit big. So I only see one part of the slide deck. Yeah, I only see the left half. I'm not sure if it's, I think maybe you can make it smaller. Sorry for interrupting. Yes, I mean, in the worst case, we could leave it. I'm not sure if we, yeah, so I see this half. So maybe it needs to be.
I have made it fully on the screen. And this is the problem.
Yeah, I can only see a small part of it, actually.
Okay. I have sent you, but maybe I take the PDF. Maybe it will work better. Let's try to change to the PDF, okay?
Yes, yes, take your time. We have time. What would be a tech event without technical problems, right? So super boring. We actually planned it. And so let me use this for 1 second. Please feel free to direct questions directly to Brigitte in the Q&A section, and you can vote for them. So the questions that will be there and directed to Brigitte, I will ask her them in the follow-up.
So what do you see now?
Still the old screen, the old old presentation screen. Okay, yeah.
And now?
Yeah, I think it's still a bit cut at the side.
Maybe the format, yes, it's too broad.
Mm-hmm. Ah, now it's good. Yeah, that's good. And maybe scroll down a little bit, like this, perfect, and scroll down a little bit.
Okay.
And also Manuela put a very smart comment. She said to change to presentation mode, but you had it in presentation mode before.
I had it in presentation mode, yes.
And this is now the PDF, right?
This is the PDF, yeah.
But I can see everything now. So maybe scroll down to the graphic.
And now?
Better, but still a small bit cut off on the side. But I can see all three pillars. Perfect. And yes, let's keep it like this. Yes, good.
Okay, good. I'll share the PDF with all the others afterwards, okay?
We have it in the shared drive, yeah. So we should post a link to the shared drive one more time, and it's in there for everyone who wants to watch in parallel. Thank you so much, and sorry, Brigitte, for interrupting.
It fits now for you?
I can see now the entire slide, yeah.
Okay, fine. So we were at the three pillars of our data excellence strategy. The data governance with the organization, the roles, the processes, the big thing with data quality management and the enterprise data management, it means to have all the tools in our data center and the technical part to manage our data in the right way. Do you see the next slide now, if I scroll in this way?
Yeah.
Yeah. We started with our vision of the data excellence organization of the city of Vienna. This was our target picture from the beginning, I think 3 years ago, where we said we want to end here with this virtual organization belonging data in the city. The sponsor for Data Excellence is our CIO. I work for the office of the CIO. Then we have a strategic steering board, Data Excellence. And in the middle of this picture, you see me in the role of Data Governance Coordinator. I also lead the operational Data Governance Steering Board, where our data stewards meet once a month. I coach our data stewards. They coach the data experts we have in each department of the city, and they coach the data users. The data stewards are a role for so-called data domains. For example, we have data domains for personal data of the employees, of financial data, of the addresses of the city, for the green gardening, like the trees in Vienna. So they have the strategic role to look over this data and also the data quality of this data. And the data experts are responsible for the usage of the data in every department. And the data users, they have the active role handling with data in the data supply process. They also have access to the source systems, but they also can be people who make data analytics, for example. On the right side, we have the data consumers. Some are in the city of Vienna, management who becomes reports, but also the citizens, the economy and the science, for example, people who use our open data. And on the left side, you see our MA01, that's the department Vienna Digital, our data center, where we have a group data excellence who does all the technical things belonging to data. And we also have an office for data analytics in our MA23, that's the department for economy and statistics. And we work together also with the Wiener Stadtwerke, public utilities, belonging to data, also for data analytics, with the Wiener Linien, for example, for data of the public transport. We started with this picture, as I said. Nowadays, we have, I think, more than 20 data stewards in their job, or in their role, which they make in their line of business job, and the data experts, I think we have 170 now. To help them all to do their job, we have identified 8 topics in the data excellence where we made guidelines for them. The guidelines were written by the members of our steering committee. For example, we have guidelines for the data excellence organization, business data model, reference data management, master data management, for the data usage, which means how must reports look like, how do we publish open data, for data risk management, and for the demand management, how we handle with a new project, for example, where data is produced. And all these guidelines come down from the data excellence strategy, are led by the data excellence strategy. So you would say a big challenge for all these people, yes, we know. So we also have a data excellence training program for them. It's building up. You must read it from bottom to the top. We are starting with e-learnings for every employee of the city of Vienna, with basic trainings available in our virtual Vienna Academy as e-learning modules. And there we have modules, for example, for data excellence, short to the point for all, Data Excellence Organization for All and also modules for Open Government Data for All or Vienna Geoinformation for All. For our data experts and data stewards, we have advanced trainings. These are classroom trainings to all these data excellence topics. We have special seminars if people work with us in data excellence projects. And we also want to establish a data excellence community where we have internally regularly meetups where the people can exchange on all these data excellence topics. So becoming data excellence, it has to be planned, and so we established a project for the establishment of the data excellence services. It's called PEDES, and there we have four objectives. We want to roll out and consolidate the data governance. We want to fill our Vienna DX Center, that's the name for our data warehouse, with quality-proof data. Our data center, the group Data Excellence and Vienna Digital, ensures the technical data quality management, and the departments who are specialists for the data, they ensure the data quality management from their side. We are running this program since 3 years, and I think we have quite good results. We have established an 8-step method, which starts with the first meeting with the top management of a department who wants to start a data excellence program with us. And then there is a kickoff to clarify the collaboration, agree to the timeline, secure the objectives of the streams. Then there we have a plan also for a training for the people who are working with us in these streams. And then we have an agile method to implement and run the data in the data warehouse. We start with a business model. We have an analysis between, and we have this implementation, which runs in different streams. The final parts of such projects are the training for the people. They learn about the tool set for data usage. Then we want to have the data excellence KPIs for them. So we say which KPIs should the data stewards deliver the next time for us. And the final step is to write a nice success story for the management, that they know where the money goes of this project. Here you see a data excellence strategy map, which was the basis for our data excellence strategy. You see the dimensions. They begin with the employees and the internal development, for example, to increase the data excellence competence, which we want to reach with the e-learnings for all, to have the same language, to have the same understanding of data. And our job is to have satisfied customers in the city. So we want to increase the extent of services for our data consumers, or we want to improve citizen services through data and through our data excellence initiative. How do we measure our initiative? We have five central data excellence KPIs. The first one is about data quality. The second one about the business data model. The third one, the level of maturity of a department. This is a self-assessment. The KPI 4 is about data usage. There we mean how many reports quality proofed, how many data is published as open data, for example. And KPI 5 is the effort within the data lifecycle, also a self-assessment of the departments. What do you have from this data excellence strategy? In the data excellence strategy, which was published 2019, we have the leading principle open by default. The city of Vienna publishes open data since 2011. I think we have a lot of experience with open data, and one of the first data sets was this tree register I mentioned before, with over 485,000 trees in the city of Vienna. So we said open by default is, when you want to say, a marketing effect, an additional marketing effect, because the open by design we have internally in our DNA of data handling in the city of Vienna. And we have published open data sets on our data portal, data.wien.gv.at. Nowadays, I think we have over 500 data sets, but we don't only publish data because we have a strategy. We publish open data because we want that you make apps, that you use this data. And we know about more than 290 apps which use the open data of the city of Vienna. Some examples, apps which use the real-time data of the public transport. But back to the trees of Vienna, there are 15 apps who use the tree register. For example, there is one app where you can look, it's called Fruit Fly, where you can pick fresh fruit in the city, or another app with virtual reality. If you stand in front of a tree, you can see if a chestnut tree, and how old is he, and how big is he in meters. And what's the benefit for us of open data? I think also a quality measurement, because again, an example for the for the feedback we can become of open data. A developer of Berlin, we know him personally, he posted someday, you must have a giant tree in the city, 100 meters diameter. And yeah, we looked at the data, and it wasn't 100 meters, it was 100 centimeters. And what happened? The employee who measures the trees yearly forgot to set a comma. The tree was 98 centimeters the year before, now 100 centimeters, and the comma was set on the wrong position. So what left from this story? We have a story about this. Maybe you find the story about a giant tree in Vienna. I will later post the link to this story. But for us, it's good to have additional 4th, 6th, and 10th eyes looking on our data, and help to increase the data quality. What do we else? We are looking for a digital twin of the city of Vienna, and here you see a model of urban data platforms. It is a study of the Erasmus University Rotterdam 2019, who looked over cities in Europe and said this would be the target architecture picture for an urban data platform. We also have such an urban data platform in Vienna. It's called smartdata.wien. And here you have our architectural picture built from Lego bricks. We use an Open Standard platform for our urban data platform. It's called Fiverr. Maybe you know it. If not, you can Google for it. It uses open standards, open APIs, and open data models. And for the technical interested people, we have here some from the of the platform buildings and bricks we use in the city. I also can recommend our open government implementation model. If someone is from a big organization, maybe you can use this implementation model for your own organization. It's open available. And on the right side, you see we are also active in a cooperation, Open Government Data Dachlitz. This means Germany, Austria, Switzerland, and Liechtenstein. And together we have created this version 3.0, which is the last also available in English. I always say open data are borderless, or data are borderless. Rania, I hope I'm allowed to take the picture of women in data science also in this picture. We have a big open data community in Vienna, which you see on the baseline. We work together in the cooperation Open Government Data Austria, where you heard before I'm a founding member. The Open Data of Austria you find on our national data catalog data.gv.at, and all this metadata is also harvested to the European data portal, europeandataportal.eu. We are active in open and agile smart cities, and I'm happy to have, a good open data community in Vienna, where we know a lot of people personally, and a lot of hackathons and meetups are made based on your open data. And so maybe this is also one of the things why open data makes so much fun for us all. I want to figure out one offensive. You see here on the left side, the Data Intelligence Offensive of Austria. It's also a Verein, a non-profit organization where I'm vice president. And shortly, I want to explain it. It's a cooperation platform which connects data producers, data processors, and data users. We work on creating an open and transparent data ecosystem. How do we do it? We are working in working groups and data circles. Example for such working groups are mobility, data and law, technical integration. And examples for data circles could be logistics in the automotive industry, tourism demand, predictive maintenance. And if you're interested to participate, you can do it as a supporter, as a member, or as a multiplier. And here you have a picture about our members today. So if you're interested, write me an email or a little posting, then you can also be part of this initiative. But now back to Vienna. What will be different when the city of Vienna becomes data excellent? We want to have a data map, an internal data map with the responsibilities to the data in our intranet. And so we can reduce search costs for data. We want to know what our golden source is for the data. We want to have our data consumers to trust on our reports and our data. And the last point, our data treasure of the city is optimally used, and we are ready for a digital twin of Vienna. So what you should know about our Open Data in Vienna, we are the pioneer of open data in the German-speaking countries. In 2011, we opened up our portal. We publicate new open data in quarterly data phases since May 2011. The next data phase is number 41. Since 2017, we have our program to establish the data excellence in the city. Since 2019, we have our data excellence strategy with our leading principle open by default. Here you have some links. And I have a little bonus then for the German speakings. I will post the link. I think it's a nice video, but in German, what is data excellence in der Stadt Wien? I will post the link afterwards in the chat for you. And I also want to thank you very much for the invitation. And I also have a question for you. Do you use open data? And if yes, which portals? Hopefully also the Viennese portal. And if no, why not? Maybe lack of trust or other reasons. And now I'm open for your questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Brigitte. This was an amazing talk. Woo! From here, from our location in Talent Garden, where Weir Developers is hosting us. And we are very thankful to that. So Brigitte, it was a fantastic talk, giving you us a great overview of all the activities. And I wasn't actually aware of how pioneering the city of Vienna was. So the question section was quite busy. I think you answered quite some questions throughout the talk. But something I was wondering about also, I mean, you mentioned the cooperation with the DACH region and you said that Vienna was pioneering. But the first question was, Brigitte, did you have other cities to look to concerning best practices, or did you have to come up with all these strategies yourself?
We are really a pioneer. We had to start by ourselves. In 2010, nobody in Middle Europe or in Austria knew a lot of open data. So we worked together with the universities and some stakeholders who knew what the word open government data means. And there our first version of the implementation model was written from a colleague from Bernhard Grabina and me and from the...
Oh, Brigitte, you are on mute, I see. Somehow I think there is something with the microphone. Oh, yeah, I think we lost. You're here. Great. Perfect. There was a short cut.
It was a short cut, yes. You heard about the implementation model. We had some people who helped us with the first strategy. And now the other cities in Europe come to Vienna. But we also had the cooperation Open Government Data in Austria, where we worked together with the cities of Linz and cities in Salzburg and Graz. And so the first steps we made together in this Open Data part. And the Data Excellence Strategy, again, we had some helpers in the background. But now I think we have a lot of experience to share with others.
Great.
I have to look at the
There are three questions that I would try to get together into one, basically. So it's all about how many data scientists do you employ, and do you actually use machine learning? Then the other question is, first of all, thank you for this enlightening talk. And then the question is, how many women data scientists do you employ? And the last question is it hard to hire data steward people for data steward jobs?
Okay, we don't have a lot of data scientists, I think, in the city of Vienna. 15. I think we have some women, maybe five of them are women. And yeah, the hiring of data stewards, we begin softly. At the beginning of a project, we say we need the data specialists, and they are here now. They don't have the role of the data steward. And in the program PEDES, they learn to how to handle the data, how to handle the data lifecycle. They make the training programs. And in the middle of the program, then they themselves say, now I think I'm a data steward. And then the management of the department has to nominate this person because it's clear that they also need time for the job. So we take time, and I'm sure that we find the right persons for these roles, but softly.
Yeah, no, thank you. Actually, a question that is also kind of a bit related to the question on whether you're using AI. So the question is, thank you so much for this presentation. It is so crucial to have reliable, validated data to work with. We often tend to be distracted by fancy AI models and forget about the importance of data source. Who are your top consumers?
Top consumers are, I think, app developers. There we know the apps which they post on our data portal. We don't know all our consumers of open data because you need no barrier to use this data. You only take the data. We have the Creative Commons CC BY license where you have to write the data source is City of Vienna and nothing else. But if you're nice, you post your usage on our portal, and then we know this usage and we can help you if you have problems, if you change the source of data, and our data producers are happy to see what happens with the data. So they are animated to publish more data if they see, for example, open data is also used for AI models or something for that, like that.
Yeah, thank you so much, Brigitte. Actually, there are more questions pumping in, and one can really see you get a lot of traction with the topic and also regarding exactly in what you answered now. So I would invite you to go into the Q&A and help us answer the questions. I think you can do that.
I will do it. Okay.
And, also, please, because you had so many interesting posts to share, shares like data strategy, the data portal, please, can you send the links to all these interesting initiative pages in our chat? And that's actually my closing words. So thank you so much for this amazing talk. It was very interesting, and we can really see that from the questions pumping in. And
thank you very much.
And we will write an email to you for a cooperation. To be.
Yes, will do, will do. I'm happy. Thank you very much.
And if I'm not mistaken, this brings me to our last break for today. So we have another 10 minutes, so please stick with us. I actually saw that many of you managed to stay the first break, so come back because a great talk is waiting for you. And we will be back at 12:05 right here. Don't leave us now and hold
in
there.
Stay in the chat.
Yeah, please.
Stay in the chat and Q&A. Brigitte will be answering questions in the Q&A as well.
Thank you so much, and see you in 10 minutes.